Hey everybody, what's going on? Joel Irwin with DailyFEExamPrep.com, and in this video we are going to be talking about circles with regards to center and radiuses. So this is going to fall under mathematics and advanced engineering mathematics and analytic geometry and trigonometry if you're following along with the general FE exam specification. So let's hop right into it. So today's problem is, what are the coordinates of the center and radius of a circle given the following equation of x squared plus y squared plus 10y minus 2x plus 16 is equal to 0? All right, now this looks a little intimidating at first, but if you can break it down into a couple sub-problems, this is actually really, really simple. Okay, so the first step that you want to do is, first of all, you want to reference the NCEES supplied reference handbook that will be given to you in the exam. And so let's just go ahead and find where that problem is located right now. I've already pulled it up for you. It is on page 23 of the mathematics section. So 23 total. And here is the equation of the circle. So the equation is given as x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared, where the center is given at hk coordinates, and this is the standard form of the equation with the radius. And the radius is given as the square root of x minus h squared plus y minus k squared. Okay, so make sure that you have that formula handy, and let's get rolling. Okay, so let's go ahead and write that equation down, the standard form of a circle. We know it to be x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared. So we're given the circle equation as up here, and this is the expanded form. Now what we want to do is we need to get it into binomial form because we want to find the coordinates of the center. Okay, so what we can tell from this equation here, the equation of a circle, is that we need to get them into identical binomials, into x minus h squared format. Okay, so let's break it down even further. So let's tackle the x equation first. So if we just completely forget about everything that doesn't have an x related to it, we get x squared minus 2x. Okay, so we know that we need to get this into quadratic equation form because we need to get it into this x minus h binomial squared format. So in order to do that, we know that there's going to be a third part somewhere in there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to expand that, and we are going to try and figure out what that third component is. All right, so the way that you do this is you want to reference back, remember the FOIL method, the first, outer, inner, last, where you're going to, that's how you expand two binomials. Well, basically we want to kind of work backwards, okay? So we want to figure out what this value is, the h value, that will give us minus 2x, okay? So if we're doing the first, outer, inner, last, we can kind of backtrack into it. So basically, what two numbers are going to add up to give us this minus 2x format? Well, I know the answer, and I want you to figure it out, but the answer is going to be something that adds up to minus 2x, okay? So there's not much that that adds up to minus 2, all right? So, and it needs to be two integers. So for the sake of saving time, let's work with the answer here. So it's actually minus 1, x minus 1 times x minus 1. Okay, remember this is x minus 1 squared, just like we have up here. Okay, so let's just work it out real quick. First, outer, inner, last, so we've got x squared minus 1x. Now the inner terms, minus 1x plus 2. And then if we simplify that, we get x squared minus 2x plus 2. Okay, so that is exactly what we have here. And we now know that that question mark is going to be plus 2. So our x minus h squared term is actually x minus 1 squared. So let's go ahead and do that for y. For the y part of the equation, we have y squared plus 10y plus some third format, okay? So remember, when we get down to that, when we get down to, when we're breaking it down into our two terms, our two binomials, and we're messing around with the first, outer, inner, last, we know that we've got y. This is a given. Now, we just need to figure out what two items during our outer and our inner steps are going to give us an addition of 10y, a total sum of 10y. So since we're looking to get this into a format where we are squaring the term, we know that this k plus k value, or this, excuse me, we know that whatever adds up to 10 has to be one number, has to be the same number. So it has to be, you know, for instance, 5 plus 5. 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. But regardless, we know that it has to be the same number because we are squaring this total binomial. So we know that the number has to be 5, okay? So let's just try it. Y plus 5 times y plus 5. And if we expand that, we know we get y squared plus 5y plus 5y plus 25. Okay, so that works. Y squared plus 10y plus 25. Okay, so if you just take it slow and kind of work backwards and then think about what you need to get, what format you need to get that in, this problem turns out to be a whole lot simpler. Okay, so simplifying that, we have y squared plus 10y plus 25. Okay, so we know that 25 is now our missing third term here. Okay, so let's just keep that in mind. Okay, so let's move on to the next step, which we know is, let's just write out everything that we've solved for thus far. So let's get it into the equation form. So we have x minus 1 squared plus y plus 5 squared plus 16 is equal to 0. Well, it's not actually equal to 0, okay? So since we now have these two binomials figured out, you know, when they're expanded, remember that we had a plus 1 for the x minus 1 squared, and we also had plus 25. Well, since we added it to this left-hand side of the equation, we also need to add it to the right-hand side of the equation. So we're gonna have over here plus 1 plus 25. Okay, so now the next step that we want to do is we want to get this 16, this value of 16 over to the right hand side as well. So what we'll do is we will subtract this from the total, and that gives us x minus 1 squared plus y plus 5 squared plus 10. Okay, so a total value of 10 is on the right hand side of the equation. Now we can find our coordinates. Okay, so we know that according to the equation that we found in the FE exam reference handbook, the center is at HK. Okay, now remember, the formula that we were given was x minus h squared plus y minus k squared is equal to r squared. So these numbers that we have plugged in to our equation, they are actually the negative value, okay? So we are actually looking at the minus h term and the minus k term. So why is that important? Well, this is a very, very simple way for them to trip you up on the exam, because h and k are actually 1 minus 5. The negative values of what we were given here. And the value of the radius is the square root of 10, okay? So if we look at the formula just one more time, if we're in the standard equation of the circle, x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared, okay? So we need to take the square root of our value that we had on the right-hand side of the equation to get our final value. So to make this lesson, to end this lesson as quickly as possible, our final answer is hk is equal to 1 minus 5, and the radius is equal to the square root of 10. Be sure to check out my other problems at dailyfeexamprep.com, and feel free to share this if you found this any at all helpful. So thank you again for watching, and I will talk to you soon.